Hi, Kevin here again. I'm a health and safety professional, and this channel is all about making health and safety easier to understand, clear, and practicable or doable for everybody. Today, I want to talk to you about the difference between hazard, risk, and consequence. You know, a few years back, I was working with a group of folks. They were carpenters and cabinet makers, and we got to talking about table saws. The funny thing is I asked them, okay, what is the hazard when using a table saw? And a bunch of them said, well, cutting off your fingers. Yeah, I suppose that's a big thing. So I said, okay, well, what's the risk then involved when using a table saw? And they said, well, cutting off your fingers. Okay, going forward, what's the consequence? Well, cutting off your fingers. Okay, confused? I was. If you stick with me, let's see if we can figure out the difference between hazard, risk, and consequence. Because they're three different things, but they all apply to the hazard recognition and control process. After the intro, let's get into it. So first off, so that we're sure of it, a hazard is basically any source of potential damage that can harm or adversely affect the health of someone or something can be adversely affected or damaged. If you go to the Canadian Centre for Occupational Health and Safety, they'll bring this out into a large expanded definition for you. But let's put it in the simplest terms. A hazard is basically something that has a negative effect or an adverse effect on anything it interacts with. So with people, it's going to cause injury or illness. With property or assets, there's going to be harm or damage. And with the environment, once again, more harm or damage. So going to our table saw analogy that we talked about earlier, basically one of the hazards, if we were to consider it, is an unguarded blade. A lot of times people that you experienced users with a table saw will take the guard off for lots of different reasons. One off the bat is a plunge, making a plunge cut. If you want to know what a plunge cut is, search YouTube, it'll show you. Now, risk, getting on to risk. We talked about hazard earlier, so now risk. Risk is the chance or probability of the manifestation of a consequence after that negative interaction with the exposure to a hazard. One of the things that you want to consider with risk is risk increases, or the chance of probability, it directly corresponds with time duration, frequency, and repetition. So if you're using a table saw once a week, your risk of something occurs is not nearly as of something, your risk of something occurring is not nearly as bad or as great as if you're using it several times a day and repeating that process daily every week. Frequent exposure to that unguarded blade causes risk to increase, or the chance of something occurring increases. And now consequence. Consequence, to simply put it, a negative result of the exposure to the hazard after being exposed to it frequently causes a severe outcome. So injury has occurred. And injury, just put it injury, whether it be minor soft tissue injury, small cut to your finger, or a cataclysmic one where you've lost a bunch. Don't mean to bring up any bad memories for those that have lost fingers. So basically that's how it works. So let's look at all of this together, examining our table saw analogy. So once again, going to the back to the table saw, the hazard is the exposed or unguarded blade for whatever reason. Risk is the probability that adverse consequences might occur, which are increased by the exposure, which of course is influenced by the frequency, the repetition, and or the duration, or all three together. Consequence itself is the adverse outcome. Getting injured, damage, etc. Okay, I hope that gives you a better understanding of the three things. And as I said, this video is basically a springboard into the hazard recognition and control process and playlist that I'm creating. Once again, please, if you like the content, let me know below. If you haven't already, subscribe, hit the subscribe button, and ring the little bell, and you'll get notification of new content. Until then, thank you very much, and please remember, thinking, talking, and doing safety helps us to provoke safety at home and in the workplace. So that's it. Bye for now, and I'll see you again.